IPv6 Tunneling Explained. We're going to wrap up this series on IPv6 by showing you IPv6 tunneling and how it works and why we need to use it. So stay tuned. If you haven't already, hit that button to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when I release new videos each week. Okay, so we've talked about IPv6 protocols and IPv6 in these other videos. I'd invite you to watch them as soon as you can. In this short video, I'm going to show you IPv6 tunneling explained as simply as possible, and not only why we need tunneling, but how it's basically used in the current networking world. If you don't already know, tunneling technology is used in other ways. We primarily use tunnels in VPNs, or virtual private networks. And just to give you a basic rundown on how a tunnel works, you create a connection between two devices on a network, typically two routers. This network could be a private network. It can even be as small as two devices connected directly to each other, or it can be over the internet. Regardless of what network is used, the two devices, again, typically routers or layer 3 devices, both devices agree on an encryption method for sending information to and from each other. And they will take certain types of data and encapsulate it into that encryption type data that only the two of them understand. If their connection or signal is detected or read anywhere along the way by any device or person, it's basically gibberish, because the only two devices that know how to encrypt it are the ones using it at either end of the connection. This is called a tunnel because it's essentially the same as creating a physical tunnel to go underneath or around something and still provide a means of passage. In this case, a means of passage for data to be sent back and forth. VPNs, or virtual private networks, use tunneling to allow remote users, in most cases, to connect to their own network, maybe say a company network or a college network, or whatever the network is that they want to connect to. They can connect to that network when they're out in public connecting over the internet. And this is to prevent anyone or any devices in between from having the ability to translate or understand the information in the connection if they're able to somehow see it. With that basic understanding of tunnels, we now get to tunnels used in IPv6. Now, most, if not all, operating systems in the present day support and can use IPv6. Most, if not all, professional level routers support IPv6. However, there are still quite a number of home routers that do not. Another thing to consider is that not all routers on the internet have IPv6 support enabled or turned on. So even though most of us would like to start moving over to IPv6 across the board, we are inhibited by this one fact alone. For IPv6 to work, every router on the internet has to work with IPv6 between those two connections. So how do we get around this if we want to use IPv6? How do we bridge that gap? That's where tunneling comes into play. This is done by implementing what's called an IPv4 to IPv6 tunnel. This technology offers multiple ways to traverse that gap, and there are many IPv4 to IPv6 standards that can be used. An IPv4 to IPv6 tunnel works like any other tunnel. It encapsulates one type of data into another. In our scenario, we want to encapsulate IPv6 traffic into an IPv4 tunnel to allow it to reach the other IPv6 capable router on the other end of the connection. Which leads us to the 6-to-4 standard. 6-to-4 is a tunneling standard or protocol that allows IPv6 traffic to be sent over IPv4 networks without having to have explicit tunnels created and maintained, usually by what are called tunnel brokers, and those can get quite expensive and hard to maintain. 6-to-4 is typically used for connecting two routers directly because it requires a public IPv4 address. A 6-to-4 address will always start with 2:00:16. If you're using an IPv6 capable router, or you have a computer directly connected to the internet, you can set up a 6-to-4 tunnel for use. And I would invite you to Google this or look up the steps for setting up a 6-to-4 tunnel. It might come in handy someday. 6-to-4 will actually use public relay routers all around the world. You can search online for how to set up 6-to-4 tunnels to prevent having to use what are called tunnel brokers, like I spoke about a few seconds ago. And tunnel brokers would set up established tunnels to be used. Again, those can be expensive and kind of difficult to maintain if you don't necessarily need them all the time, or if you just want to set up a 6-to-4 tunnel across an internet connection. The last thing we're going to point out here is that in 6-to-4 tunnels, one IP address, 192.88.99.1, is known as an Anycast address, and it works everywhere. You'll also need to know about Teredo and Marado. Teredo is an IPv6 tunneling protocol that uses NAT traversal, network address translation. If you don't know about NAT, I'll be talking about it in an upcoming video. And Teredo is built into Microsoft Windows. Teredo addresses always start with 2001:0000:32. Marado is an implementation of Teredo that's actually more open source, and it's been developed for use with Linux and several other Unix-based systems. So there you have it. That's IPv6 tunneling explained, and this wraps up the basics of what you need to know about IPv6 for the Network Plus exam, and really mostly covers the areas of understanding IPv6 that you will need to pass the CCNA exam if and when you decide to take that. So with that being said, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.